Hello everyone, welcome back to part 20 of our Endless Runner tutorial series. Today, I'm going to show you how to optimize your Endless Runner game. Now let's get started. These tips apply to all types of projects, whether for Windows, Android, or any other platform. I've also included some optimization settings specifically for Windows and Android, which you can check out using the timestamps in the description. First, to check detailed stats of the game performance, in the project viewport, open the viewport options by clicking on the three bars on the viewport, and enable Show Stats. Now click on the Stats option below, hover on Engine, and enable Detailed Stats. You can now see the stats on your viewport. When optimizing your game, make sure that the draws and prims are as low as possible. Ideally, draws should be under 300 and prims should be under 250k. Now the first tip for optimization is to use Level of Detail or LOD. Levels of detail are the low-poly versions of your original model used to improve performance by reducing detail at a distance. If you are using models from Quixel Bridge or Quixel Megascan assets, they already have levels of detail. But if your models don't have levels of detail, you can create them easily in Unreal Engine itself. First, open the model that you want to create LOD for. For this video, I'm going to add levels of detail to just one building asset from Kitbash 3D. Now to create levels of detail, in the Details tab, scroll down until you see LOD settings. From the LOD group dropdown, select the option based on what type your mesh is. Here I selected Level Architecture as the object is a building. When you get the pop-up, click Yes. If your mesh already has levels of detail, this will overwrite the old LODs and create a new one. As you can see, when I move away from the mesh, the level of detail changes, but you can barely notice it. In the LOD settings, you can also specify the number of LODs you need. By default, Unreal Engine will create 4 whenever you create a new level of detail. To customize the distance where the level of detail changes, disable Auto Compute Distance in the LOD settings. In the LOD picker, you can select the different levels of detail and see how the mesh looks and also see the triangle count. When you select a level of detail, you will see that there is a LOD 0 or LOD 1 section in the Details tab. You can change the screen size value of each LOD so that it will change the level of detail of the mesh if the mesh screen size is less than the mentioned screen size. In the reduction settings, you can increase or decrease the mesh triangle count. The second tip is to use texture mipmaps. Mipmaps are smaller versions of a texture that help the game run smoother by showing less detail when you're far away from an object. When you import a texture, Unreal Engine will automatically create mipmaps if the texture size is power of 2. But if the texture is not power of 2 or it doesn't have mipmaps, you can create mipmaps by going to the Details tab in the Level of Detail section, then from MipGen settings select from Texture Group and save the texture. The third tip is to reduce the image resolution. If the texture resolution is 2K or 4K, it will increase the game size and reduce performance on low-end devices. Reducing the texture resolution can save space and also improve performance. To compress the image resolution, open the texture in Unreal Engine, and in the Details tab, go to the Compression section, click on Advanced, and set the max texture size to 1024. If you are making the game for Android, you might want to set the max texture size to 512. The texture I currently have opened is 1024 by 1024, so if I set the max texture size to 512, it will change the max in-game resolution to 512 and also reduce the disk size. If the max texture size is 0, it will set the max in-game resolution to the original resolution of the image. You can also set the max texture size for textures in bulk via Property Matrix. Simply go to the folder where your textures are located, select all of them by holding Shift and right-clicking on the textures, then click on Asset Actions, and then click on Bulk Edit via Property Matrix. In the Property Matrix, Display tab, expand the Compression section and set the max texture size to your desired value. The fourth tip is to migrate the project to a new project to clear all the unused assets. To do that, make sure you create a blank Unreal project. In the Endless Runner project, go to the Runner folder and then the Maps folder. Select all the maps that you want in the game by holding Ctrl, right-click, choose Asset Actions, and click on Migrate. It will show a pop-up with a list of all the assets that are used in those maps. Clicking on OK will migrate all the selected assets in the pop-up. When you click OK, it will open a File Explorer window. Go to the blank project folder and select the content folder to migrate the files. This is useful if you have a lot of unused assets downloaded from the marketplace or imported from Bridge, as they take up a lot of disk space. The fifth tip is to lower the draw distance. Draw distance is how far you can see objects in a game. A longer draw distance shows more but can reduce performance. A shorter draw distance improves performance by showing less. Lowering the draw distance of some objects like obstacles and coins will improve performance a lot. I'm adding draw distance for a coin, so go to the Blueprints folder and open BP_coin. Select the coin static mesh and in the Details tab, scroll down until you see the LOD section and expand it. Set the desired max draw distance as you wish. For coins, I found that a max draw distance between 5,000 to 7,000 is perfect. I'll show you if it works by setting the draw distance to 2,000. As you can see, when I play, the coins started appearing after I cross a certain distance. Now let's see some rendering settings for Windows and project settings. For Android settings, check the timestamp in the description. You can open project settings by clicking on the edit button on top and clicking on project settings. In project settings, scroll down until you see rendering in the engine section. Here in the settings, you will see texture streaming, keep it checked. You can enable virtual textures if you want, but I'm not enabling it. For global illumination and reflection method, you can set it to lumen. You can set the reflection capture resolution to 64 if you want to. For hardware ray tracing, if you are making the game for low-end devices, then I do not recommend hardware ray tracing. If you are using DirectX 12 and SM6, then I highly recommend you use Nanite, it will improve performance a lot. But if you are using DirectX 11 and SM5, I recommend you use LODs as Nanite is not supported for SM5 and DirectX 11. If you are making the game for very low-end devices, you can use forward shading. The same renderer is used for mobile games made in Unreal Engine. If you have auto exposure enabled, disable it. For anti-aliasing method, choose TSR or TAA. FXAA looks bad, so I recommend you use TSR or TAA. If you are using forward shading, then use MSAA as it is only supported in forward shading. Now let's check settings for Android. These settings are very important for Android and affect performance a lot. In Project Settings, go to Render Settings. You will see the first section for mobile. For mobile shading, you can set it to forward shading or deferred shading. Both look very similar, and I did not find much difference between them, so I recommend forward shading as it also supports low-end devices. Set the mobile anti-aliasing method to MSAA. Mobile float precision mode has to be use half precision. You can disable support movable light CSM shader culling, but it will also disable all cascade shadows from directional light, so I won't be disabling it. You can disable enable local light support on mobile forward, and also disable support desktop Gen 4 TAA on mobile. You can enable virtual textures for mobile, but I don't really recommend it. Reduce the reflection capture resolution to 64. The global illumination and reflection method can be anything, as it doesn't matter when packaging to mobile. It will only use forward shading or deferred shading. Same with Nanite, mobiles don't support Nanite. In miscellaneous lighting, disable allows static lighting. In default settings, disable bloom and ambient occlusion. You can also disable everything in the shader permutation reduction, but I'm not doing that. After changing all the settings, restart the engine. Now in the viewport, you can preview how the game looks on an Android device. For that, click on Settings on the top right, then hover on Preview Rendering Level and select Android ES 3.1. It will take a while to change the preview, so be patient. Now the preview mode has changed to Android, and you can see the Android logo beside the play button above the viewport. When I click on play, you can see the game looks really bad with no shadows. That's because I still haven't restarted the editor. you still have to change one more thing. In Project Settings, go to Target Hardware. If your Target Hardware says Desktop, change it to Mobile, and it will show some settings that will modify it. It will disable anti-aliasing for mobile, so you have to enable it again in Render Settings after restarting the engine. But I forgot to turn on anti-aliasing after restarting the engine. You also have to set the MSAA count to 2x. More than 2x can reduce performance on older mobiles. I've restarted the engine. Now when I press play, you can see the shadows, and the game is looking a lot better now. When I turn on detailed stats, you can see that I'm getting stable FPS, but draws and prims are very high. You have to create LODs and lower the texture size as I've mentioned before, and I haven't done any of that yet, but I will show the final result later with stats. I recommend you delete volumetric clouds from the level, as they can reduce performance. This is currently on Epic Settings. I'll change the scalability to medium, and you will see that the character shadows have disappeared, and instead, there is some dark blurry area. The shadow quality has also reduced. To fix that, select the directional light from the outliner and, in the Details tab, scroll down until you see Cascade Shadow Maps and decrease the dynamic shadow distance to something between 5000 to 10,000. It will increase the shadow quality, but it will also reduce the draw distance of the shadows. The higher the value, the lower the quality of the shadow, but setting the value too low can make the game look very bad, and I don't recommend going below 5000. You might have also noticed that the glass material of the building looks bad. If you have imported it through cargo, to find the master material, go to the cargo folder, then the materials folder, and finally the master folder. In the master folder, open the master underscore translucent material, and in the details tab on the right, set the blend mode to opaque and save the material. Now it will remove the transparency and won't look as bad as it did before. These are some tips and settings to optimize your game for both desktop and mobile. And that's it for today's video. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you encounter any errors or need assistance, feel free to contact me via email or Discord. You can find the details in the description. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.